Hey everybody, my name is Flurbisha and welcome back to another episode of Danganronpa Trekker Happy Havoc. In the last episode, we asked Kyoko a very reasonable question of what the hell is she doing here? Who is she? Apparently she has lost her memory and she cannot tell us. Whether we believe her or not is not important right now, but Byakuya basically demanded her key so she couldn't sleep in a room. And if she doesn't sleep in a room, then she probably gets killed by Monokuma. So that's going to be interesting. Besides that, she also showed us that she has obtained a key when she asked us to distract Monokuma. Well, she asked us to meet at the data center, but that's fine. Now we're going to distract Monokuma once again. Her curt goodbye was no different from any other time. And like every other time, she moved at a brisk pace as she left. What wasn't like every other time? Was the sudden knot I felt in my stomach as I watched her walk away? No, everything's gonna be fine. I know it. Because it's Kyoko. Talking to myself helped shake off some of my anxiety. And then I get to work. Okay, let's do this. Hey Monokuma, you can see me, right? Get out of here. I've got a bone to pick with you. Then, a few moments later...
Monokuma appears!
Ah, well, this is a surprise. You being the one to call me out?
Hey!
Hey, by the way...
Huh? Most suspicious.
What were you and Kyoko up to? Going to the bathhouse? Just the two of you? In the middle of the night? Definitely a hot and steamy moment, wouldn't you say? So warm and wet. So wet and warm. I bet you guys.
Remove your conform with local and international censorship laws.
All over it, didn't you?
Did you just say that out loud instead of the actual act? What?
Not gonna talk, huh? Sure, I get it. Well, whatever, I like you. I have absolutely no interest in late night bath scenes. Because I like to maintain a healthy life of observation far away from X-rated exploits. Oh.
Oh, so is that why there's no surveillance cameras in the bathhouse?
Bullseye!
Or is it maybe because the lens gets all fucked up and you can't see anything anyway? Sounds like that's the bullseye to me.
You need something?
Anyway, you went to other trouble to get me out here? Now what you want?
Oh, well, there's just something I want to confirm with you.
Whether I'm a mademoiselle or a dude fella.
Actually...
But in the Bear Kingdom, there's no male or female.
Usually there is.
Seriously?
My entire existence!
Then what am I? My entire existence? That's enough. I'll get stuck if I think about it too much. So what did you really want to ask me?
Oh well, you told us earlier that your precious had been stolen. What's this precious of yours?
What are you thinking?
Listen, I'm sure this is a silly question. No way it's possible at all, but... Is it seriously what you dragged me out here to ask me? You can't be kidding me! You can't be 100 megaton freaking kidding me! You're gonna ask something useful like how to get the best honey or resin breeding tips? This is just crazy. Oh, pubescent teen boys. Pubescent teen boys are nutty as you.
What the heck?
God, you're so annoying. Fine, I'll tell you. It was a key and...
What?
That's it.
What was that second thing?
It's a blank, stupid. A secret. Fill it in yourself. Making me twitch all the way out here for that. I'd like to see what's going on in that brain of yours.
That concerns me that he admits the key, but he doesn't want to say the other thing. Because that means that the other thing is more important than the key, doesn't it?
And the next time you summon me for something so stupid, I'll open your skull and find out.
Probably more than a few swear words, Monokuma stormed off.
Fuck. Bitch, pussy, shit ass, goddamn fucking idiot. Whew. I hope I get him distracted long enough.
I like to imagine that, like, instead of like that he teleports or something or just disappears into like, you know what, he just like kind of slowly walks off, kicking his feet like, you goddamn fucking asshole.
Now all I can do is wait and hope Kyoko makes it out okay. I should be fine, it's Kyoko after all. I'm sure she's fine, right? I went back to my room and laid down, doing my best to settle my nerves and get back to sleep.
Oh, she's going to... She's dead, isn't she?
Monokuma Theater!
Ah, television.
Brought to you by Spike Toonsoft Company Limited!
Wait. Wait, what?
This super stylish, super fashionable of a game is created by Spike Toonsoft? Then we've got to buy it now!
You guys have to recommend it to your friends, too!
Huh? Did we just get an advertisement? In the game? What? Monokuma is a weird fellow.
Good morning, everyone! It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over! Time to rise and shine! Get ready to greet another beautiful day!
My body feels so heavy this morning. It must be because I was up so late last night. Anyway, I need to go to the dining hall. So, place your bets, everyone! Are we going to see Kyoko or is she dead? I'm betting on the dead one. Let's see. Well, I don't see Kyoko. You're 1 minute late, Makoto. How do you explain this? Sorry, I'm not feeling so great today.
What's your problem?
You really think a tired excuse like that is gonna work?
Are you allowed to talk again?
I don't recall giving you permission. I just thought, I mean, since the day had passed, is that maybe reset? Sorry, please don't hate me. What if my punishment is I'll accept it. I'll hang a sign from my neck that says bad girl. I'll clean your bathroom with my toothbrush. If you stop making disgusting comments like that, maybe I can forgive you.
Thank you. I won't make any more disgusting comments. I promise.
If I do, you can stuff my mouth full of Oh god.
There's no use, he's disgusting to the bone.
Anyway, where's Kyoko? I haven't seen her this morning.
Could it be?
Not cool. This is worse than being late for lunch. For a date, for your wedding, for anything.
Maybe she's mad about what happened yesterday. She's not gonna show up anymore. I can't tell the others why Kyoko might not be here. The best thing to do is right now is just keep quiet.
Very strange.
Whatever reason, I'm curious to know what she is doing. I know she's not in the room, so...
You know?
Oh yeah, you still have a key, right?
What if she just left the key... what if she just left the door unlocked?
What's this?
Are you looking for Miss Kirigae?
What do you want now?
Hey, I'm right? You're wondering where Miss Kirigae is, right?
Do you know where she is?
Well, it's hard to say.
You don't know either?
What?
It's because he doesn't know. That's why he's here. That's why he brought us for information.
Hey, don't you hate it when you ask someone what their favorite movie? And they name some indie bullcrap.
This is very suspicious.
I'm not getting the pleasure to wait, change stuff like that. So I guess the plan went off just last night. Which could mean...
Hey.
Maybe the mastermind can monitor us and control Monokuma at the same time. Could you have been right about that?
Hey! So, was I right? You're looking for Miss Kirigae. And any idea where she might have can. We have no idea.
What the heck?
And if we did know, we wouldn't tell you.
What the heck?
For serious. I see. Well, fine. Whatever. I don't even care anymore. Sayonara, suckers! As soon as he was gone, we all glanced around at each other. So, what was the jet just now? Does that mean Monokuma doesn't know where she is either? It would seem that way.
You know?
Where the heck could she have gone? I mean, I think we should all go look for her. And how would you suggest we approach that task? Even Monokuma can't seem to locate her.
Very suspicious.
Yeah, how can he not know where she is?
Yeah, totally.
So strange. Kyoko must have used the key to sneak into some unknown part of the school. But somewhere even Monokuma wouldn't notice? Where could it be? We spent the rest of the breakfast talking about where Kyoko could have gone. Afterwards, we returned to our rooms. Alright, time for some free time. Breakfast didn't help me feel any more upbeat, that's for sure. I feel like this is more than just me staying up late last night. Well, we can still avoid Toko and Byakuya. Let's see, where is Hiro? I guess they were all on the... Yeah. They were in the garden. You were in the dojo. And you're at the bio lab, alright. Hello, Hiro.
Oh, so then.
Monokuma seems like super advanced, right? I think maybe we've been caught in the middle of something terrible.
Very suspicious.
A global revolution by the ancient civilizations that we've ruined. The idiot technology will destroy us. You know what? I haven't considered that side of the theory yet. Interesting. Or maybe not, I don't know. Never mind. Let's spend some time. You wanna hang out with me?
It's not like some occult
mystery.
Well then,
have I got a story for you. Marisa has revealed a surprising connection between Tokyo Tower and the lost Lemurian civilization. Nero spent a lot of time talking about stuff that didn't make any sense to me. Nero knocked you a little closer today. I don't have any presents.
Well?
Because I'm saving my coins for a... Trophy. Hey Morgoto, are you familiar with Kamata? It's a tiny little suburb in Tokyo, right? Oh, that was supposed to be Hiro, never mind. You never heard of it, what about it? Well, don't tell anyone I told you this, but they appear there. What does? You amaze! Termins? Spaceships?
I'm right, right?
Yeah, no, don't worry. Oh, cryptids then.
You know?
Oh. Didn't know that had a term. You got it, and it just so happens they've been appearing in Little Old Kamata. Well, kind of cryptids.
How about that?
The terrifying skyfish, of course! In the West, they're usually just called rods. They can fly and they have a thin body and a big white fin. They can move their fins in a wave pattern, which doesn't move faster than the naked eye can see.
Could it be?
You ever heard of the Anomalocaris? Some people think that's what the skyfish evolved from. And some others think it's an artificial life form, a genetically engineered military super weapon. Isn't that scary as hell? But what would I be doing in Tokyo? And in Kamata, no less. Nobody knows. But they're doing the dangerous, you know. How close Kamata is to Haneda Airport, right? I don't want to wait till it's too late. I've been thinking I should call all the airlines. They need to know there's a way to get rid of those damn skyfish. And I know what it is. As long as they can pay my fee, I can keep things safe for them. That's what I'm gonna tell them. I wouldn't do that if I were you. I see a lot of jail time in your future if you do. Plus, isn't that like super cold? I just don't understand.
My wife, we have more skill points, but no skills to spend it on, so that's great. Once we were all done, I headed back to my room for a little while. I feel even worse than I did this morning. My body feels like lead and now I'm getting chills. This is bad. I think I might be getting sick. Alright then, let's leave the area and let's find Hina. Hina is in the laundry room. Probably doing her laundry. I mean, you have to wear the clothes that you wear every day, probably very often, right? Oh, look, it's Yunko. Oh, poor Yunko. She didn't even get a chance to be part of the game. A princess' ability is measured by the power they display at the point where pressure is applied. Yeah. That's the quote from the famous baseball player. Kenji Yojima.
Yeah, totally.
I think what he means is that you only really see how strong a person is when they're under pressure. I wonder how strong I can really be. Now let's spend some time.
You got it!
Okay, let's go to the pool. Swim time. Oh, but don't stare, okay? I don't actually have a swimsuit, just a shirt. And when it gets wet, it's kinda embarrassing. Huh? Although, I wasn't embarrassed before. But now I kinda am. I wonder how come. I went swimming with Hina, who seemed kind of embarrassed. Hina grew a little those closer today. Oh wait, no, I don't have anything. Oh. No, I don't have anything to give her, sorry. Yeah, I'm sure. Ah, so hungry.
Please!
Makoto, help me, I'm hungry. You want some donuts? I need food, anything. I don't care if it's a stack of paper, I need food. Why don't you just eat some more donuts? I can't, that's my secret weapon for emergencies only. Oh, right. If I kept quoting on something with that many calories, I'd get fat in no time. So even she cares about get that kind of thing. Well, she is an athlete, yeah, of course she cares about that. Besides, I don't want anything sugary. Right now, I want a salty snack. Like potato chips? Like ramen. How is that a snack?
You got it all wrong.
Huh? How is it not? Speaking of which, what's your favorite kind of ramen? Show you, without a doubt.
You got it!
Ah, good choice. Definitely the most refreshing option. What about you, Hina? You're worried about calories and also.
Okay.
I'm a pork. Fantastic tonkatsu girl. True and true. Oh, you don't care about calories at all. The key element of any tonkatsu ramen is the butter and the extra fat. So you're okay with all that though? Yeah, talking about just made me even hungrier. Maybe it's time, maybe I can make it to the dining hall. Are you sure though? I mean, a bottle of ramen has way more calories than a donut. Who says stuff like that? Are you a real man or aren't you? What are you afraid? Afraid of ramen? You're pathetic, Makoto. I'm ashamed to know you. Are you still Hina? Are we still having a normal conversation?
Just a second!
Shut up! Get out of my way! I'm gonna show you what a real man looks like! Or are you gonna stand in my way and suffer the fist-based consequences? No, I have no intention of getting in your way. Then don't! If I don't do this now, when am I ever gonna get another chance? Crying out like starving raven? I wonder what that sounds like. Hina ran off at a dangerous clip towards the kitchen. When it comes to food, Hina is terrifying. Hey, we got a new skill. Great. I learned my lesson and made my way back to my room. I'm getting the chills. I feel kinda dizzy. I can't help it. I need sleep. Nighttime wasn't for a while, but I felt like my body had reached its limit. As I dropped onto my bed, I felt like it was falling into a bottomless pit. I was unconscious before my head hit the pillow. Well, that's not quite true. I didn't pass out completely. It was more like my consciousness went dim. I weaved back and forth between sleep and wakefulness, which is all to say. I was restless. At some point, I found myself wandering to a strange dream. And within the dream, a voice echoed across the walls of my mind.
I understand.
That voice, it's so familiar. It's...
understand.
It's me.
I understand. I should understand everything. My goal isn't to get out of here. It's to stay here.
Huh? What am I trying to say?
This is all for hope. And that's why I have to stay. I have to stay here.
Wait, hold on. You're sleeping with your jacket on. Yeah, no wonder you're sweating as crazy.
My dream just now... What? So strange. Huh?
Oh, sup, dude?
Kyoko? What did you say?
Okay, I don't think Makoto's really right in the head right now.
Every day is peaceful. Every day is joyful. Happy days from the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep. Wishing only four of those unchanging, unending happy days, days of boredom repeating forever and ever. No abnormalities as far as here I can see. Life without the tiniest speck of abnormality.
If the world were like that, I'd consider that pretty damn abnormal.
And with that, we've got another Ding Dong Bing Pong. And I think I'm going to end this episode. Because I don't think we can put another day in like 7 minutes. Well, I guess in the next episode we'll find out what Kyoko was doing in that room. Just standing there. And maybe we know what the dream was all about. Something is going on with Makoto. Either he is sick, or maybe he has been poisoned without him knowing it. Don't think it's really poison, maybe he's just getting sick. Well, anyway, see you guys then. Goodbye.